Hello everyone, welcome again. Now we are going to discuss about structure of typical androecium and structure of its tetrasporangiate anther. These are the contents of our discussion. Structure of typical androecium, structure of tetrasporangiate anther, layers of anther wall, types of tapetum, and what are the functions of tapetum we will see. Now let's begin with structure of typical androecium. So you all know what is an androecium. Androecium is the male reproductive organ in a flowering plant, and it forms the third whorl in a flower. It is made up of one or more stamens, and each stamen is consist of two parts, basically anther and filament. So filament is a thread-like structure, or you can say it is long slender tube that holds anther at its top. And what is anther then? It is the pollen producing part of the plant, and it is made up of four chambers or segments known as pollen sacs. The anthers give rise to microspores during their development, and each of these microspores forms a pollen grain that carries the male gamete. The nucleus in the pollen grain divided mitotically to form two male nuclei. So see, androecium is the male reproductive organ in a flowering plant. And individual organ or individual part of that androecium is known as stamen, and that stamen is consist of two parts, anther and filament. So you can see this is the stamen. Here this thread like structure is known as filament, and the head like structure is known as anther. This anther is bilobed, or you can say it is dithecous. Bilobed means it is having two lobes. When you take transverse section of that anther, you will see two lobes are having four chambers. Inside that four chambers, you will see pollen sacs. There are four number of pollen sacs. Inside that pollen sacs, pollen grains are developed. Then we will see now structure of tetrasporangiate anther. The anther is a pollen grains which contribute the male gamete are formed within the anthers. That means pollen grains formed inside to that anther. The end anther shows four elongated sporogenous tissue where pollen develop. Anther in its transverse section shows four pollen sacs, and inside that pollen sacs, pollen grains develop. A normal bithecous or dithecous anther is made up of two anther lobes which are connected by a strip of sterile part called connective. A dithecous anther consists of four lobules or four sporangia, so it is said to be tetralobular or tetrasporangiate. See, this is the structure of stamen. These are two lobes and this is the filament. These two lobe or bilobe are joined together by the sterile strip of cells that is known as connective. When you take the transverse section of this anther, you will see the structure like this. So this is the one lobe and this is another lobe. Inside that single lobe, two sporangia or two pollen sacs are present. Again in another lobe, two sporangia or two pollen sacs are present. So total four pollen sacs present in a bithecous anther. And inside that pollen sac, a sporogenous tissue is present. That sporogenous tissue will give rise to pollen grain at maturity. Next, a very young anther in its transverse section show epidermis and archisporium. The archisporial cells divide periclinally, giving rise to primary parietal cells on the other side and sporogenous cell towards inner side. You can see when you take a transverse section of this anther, you will see epidermis and archisporium. This archisporium divided into outer into parietal tissue and inside sporogenous tissue. This parietal tissue again divided and develop endothecium, middle layer and tapetum. These three layers will form anther wall, and this primary sporogenous tissue inside to that archisporium will form pollen microspore mother cell, and that pollen microspore mother cell will form pollen tetrad. Tetrad means pollens are arranged in number of 4, and that pollen tetrad is give rise to pollen grains. I hope you are getting. See, I repeat, when anther in its transverse section, it will form epidermis and archisporium. Archisporium again divide perineally and get converted into parietal tissue to the outer side and sporogenous tissue towards inside. This parietal tissue will form endothecium, middle layer and tapetum. And this primary sporogenous tissue will give rise to pollen mother cell, that means that produce pollen tetrad, and that pollen tetrad will get converted into pollen grains, which is our male gamete. Now see what are the layers of anther wall. Basically there are 4 layers of anther wall known as epidermis, endothecium, middle layers and inside that middle layers tapetum. We will see discuss. Epidermis is the outermost single layer. It is compactly arranged and usually protective in function. Let's see the structure of epidermis. This outer layer is known as epidermis. It is single cell layer and the function of this epidermis is in protection. Inside that, second layer is present, that is known as endothecium. The cells of endothecium are radially elongated and show fibrous bands. The fibrous bands are made up of callus and arise from the inner tangential walls. Because of this presence of fibrous bands, this layer is otherwise called as fibrous layer. Endothecial cells help in the dehiscence of anther at maturity. See, after this epidermis, that is outer layer of anther, presence of layer that is known as endothecium, and endothecium itself a radially and compactly single cell layer. This endothecium will help in dehiscence of anther. What happens when anther get matured? It get ruptured and pollen grains will release out into the air, and the rupture of that anther will be carried out by this endothecium layer. Next to that endothecium, a 2 to 3 cell thick layer is present, that is known as middle layer. So below the endothecium, 2 to 3 layers of cells are present, which constitute middle layer, and these are act as storage center for starch. Inside to that endothecium, 2 to 3 cell thick layer is present, that is known as middle layer, and that middle layer cells are storage for starch. That means starch is stored inside that cells of that layer. Next to that middle layer, a single cell layer is present, that is known as tapetum. It is the innermost layer of anther wall and is completely surrounding the sporogenous tissue. The cells contain dense cytoplasm with prominent nuclei. Tapetum transport the nutrients to developing sporocyte. The function of tapetum is to provide nourishment and nutrients to developing sporocyte, that is to the pollen grains. The tapetum is the innermost layer of anther which surrounds the sporogenous tissue. We have seen that these are 4 pollen sacs, and these 4 pollen sacs are consist of sporogenous tissue, and this sporogenous tissue is covered with a layer of cells that is known as tapetum. This tapetum is pyramidal in shape, means the cells of this tapetum is in pyramid shape. This is the transverse section of anther, where you can see outermost layer is epidermis, below that single cell endothecium, next to that endothecium 2 to 3 layers of middle layer, and inside that middle layer presence of tapetum. And the function of that tapetum is to provide nourishment and nutrient to this sporogenous tissue. Why? Because this sporogenous tissue will give rise to the pollen grain. Okay, now there are some types of tapetum. Basically, it is of 2 types, amoeboid tapetum and glandular tapetum. So, we will see amoeboid tapetum. The tapetal cells fuse among themselves for forming a tapetal plasmodium. the protoplast of the fused tapetum cells then moves into the locule where they surround the pollen mother cells or pollen grains till their maturity. What happens in case of amoeboid tapetum? The cells of that tapetum layer get fused to each other and their wall get degenerate. And this happens in early stages of development. The amoeboid tapetum is considered as primitive type. It is also called periplasmodium tapetum. An example is Typha and Tradescantia. Here, amoeboid tapetum is the type of tapetum where the cells of that tapetum layer get fused to each other and their walls get degenerated. Only a multinuclear structure is seen. That type of tapetum is known as amoeboid tapetum. You might have seen amoeba that have no special or proper shape or size. That is coming from this amoeba and this amoeboid tapetum. Next is glandular tapetum. This glandular tapetum is also known as secretory tapetum because it secretes some substances. So glandular or secretory tapetum is the most common type of tapetum in an angiosperm where the cells remain in their original position and later break down progressively. So when at the maturity of pollen grains or the development, these glandular tapetum degenerate. Among the substances released from the degenerating tapetum are pollen heat and trichin. It forms U-ish body inside it which secretes sporopollenin. This forms thickening of exudate. So see, this glandular tapetum forms U-ish body inside it. This U-ish body secretes sporopollenin. Sporopollenin is a secondary metabolite which forms or which surrounds the pollen grain and it is necessary in thickening of exudate. So exudate, what is exudate? It is the outermost layer of pollen. So that exudate in pollen is made up of sporopollenin and it is the most resistant material in biological world. So it is found in higher monocot and many dipods. Glandular tapetum found in most of the higher monocots and many dipods. So what are the functions of tapetum? The nutrients are transported through tapetum to the sporogenous tissue. The primary function of tapetum is to provide nourishment and nutrient to the developing pollen grains. Tapetum is involved in the synthesis of callase enzyme which releases microspore tetrad by degrading callose wall. See, I have told earlier that four pollen grains are joined together with the help of substance that is known as callose. That callose is degraded by this enzyme. That is callase enzyme. When that callose is degraded by this enzyme, that four pollen grains get separated and are set free. So this tapetum is also released callase enzyme to degrade that callose wall for that pollen tetrad. Next function is tapetum plays an important role in formation of exudate. As we have seen earlier, tapetum release sporopollenin and the sporopollenin is the necessary requirement for the exudate formation. Then pollen kit. What is pollen kit? It is basically oily compound that is made up of lipid and carotenoid and is formed by tapetal layer. It is insect attractor and protect pollen from ultraviolet rays. So pollen kit is a oily compound and it is mostly present on the anther and it attracts and protects pollen grain from ultraviolet rays.